Tonight I have a group reading in Massapequa. When you lose a loved one, it is easy to carry regrets connected to their passing. Hi, Doris.
Hi, Teresa, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
But Spirit wants us to release that and embrace the good times that we shared together.
I love your house.
Thank you.
It's very me.
Yeah?
I like, and don't be insulted, I like Gordy. Can I say that?
Gordy's good.
Gordy is good. This reminds me of my grandmother's house.
Does it really?
No. So, have you guys ever been to a medium before? Okay. It doesn't matter to me if you believe in what I do. That's not what this is about. This is about you knowing that there truly is more to life than just here in the physical world, and more importantly, that your loved ones are still with you just in a different way, and that is it. Who's the young male that departed? Young for me is someone that left the physical world before we feel that time.
My husband. My name is Doris, and I'm from Massapequa, Long Island. My husband, Matthew, he was a great man. Everybody loved him. He was just happy to be alive. I miss my husband more than life.
He talks about your wedding picture. Were you just looking at the wedding picture?
I'm trying to find my wedding album. I can't find.
So know that when you do find it, he's with you at that exact moment.
When Teresa brought up the issue with my wedding album, I became emotional because I can't find it. And yes, I will find the wedding album. Teresa said I will, and I know I totally will. I take her word for it.
Do you have the big portrait still?
I just found it.
Oh, perfect.
My big portrait of us getting married, I did just find that yesterday. So it hit home.
Did you put away a picture of your husband? Because he made me look on that table over there, and I felt like there was a big picture with him in it. He goes, she hid all my pictures, Teresa. And then he shows me you going around the house. I don't know if there are pictures of him around the house, and you went around hiding his pictures. Is that correct?
Well, yeah. Yes.
It's just acknowledging that his soul was present for that. Do you understand
yes,
that?
Yes, absolutely.
Is your dad that's departed?
Yeah.
Now, do you sometimes see him in the hallway over here?
Yes.
Can I just demonstrate?
Yes.
This is him. Teresa, I'm over here! Here, here! Watch! And then he's running back and forth down the... So you see that, right?
Yeah.
When Teresa ran up the hallway and acted like my husband, oh my God, it was really funny because that's like so him.
How do you connect with the number 16?
Sweet 16. That was his party. Last party.
Did you have like a big ball gown?
Yes.
He is bragging about this dress. I mean, I feel like I can't even walk. The dress is so big. He goes, you want to see a princess? You want to see Cinderella? Gorgeous.
My daughter's 316 and actually was my husband's last celebration with his family. So it was fantastic.
He says, we dance to a song at her sweet 16, our special dance. Yeah.
It was like the wedding for my daughter. It was beautiful.
Let me ask you this. Did your husband pass sudden and or unexpected? Even if he was ill, were you not expecting him to die that
yes.
day that he died?
Right. My husband passed away 3 years ago from brain cancer. He had a glioblastoma, which usually has a 2-year span. He did great for the first year and a half with his chemo and his radiation, but then after that, he lost some of his speech. And then basically from there on in, it was just really, you know, downhill.
Now, did you want your husband to go to a different doctor? And then when they bring me to Duke?
Oh my God, that's where I wanted him to go.
You still sit after all these years and you say, we should have just packed our stuff up and went and brought him to Duke. We shouldn't have listened to anybody. He says, we made all the right choices and decisions. He needs you to release that.
Yes, I had a regret. But after she talked to me about it, I know that he doesn't blame me for anything and there is no regret for me to hold. So that definitely made me feel better.
He said, Theresa, he says, I am so blessed for the way that she loved me. She loved me unconditionally. And we had a beautiful family. Do you know how hard this is for me that I have to channel your dad? My heart breaks for you that you feel that your dad is going to miss out on so many important milestones in your life. Do you never show any emotion?
Never. I never do.
Only because when you started crying, your father said, thank you for allowing me to give my daughter permission to grieve my loss.
After the reading tonight, I think we all can move on now because there's no doubt he's with us every day.
He wants to thank you for loving him, embracing him, his soul, his memory in your life every moment of your day.
The only thing that I could say about Theresa, she's the best of the best. I love her.
Now, who passed from the chest? Because I'm having difficulty breathing.
My mother, she had lung cancer.
My name's Steven.
My name's Diane, I'm from Massapequa. My mother passed away from lung cancer 3 years ago. I miss her every day. I still reach for the phone to call her.
Did your mother always do crossword puzzles?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
Who used to try to correct them for her?
I used to do them with her.
But you are her husband, is that correct?
Because
she says, this is not my son-in-law, Theresa. She says, this is my son.
That's what she said.
I had a great relationship with my mother-in-law. When I first met her, it was a little rough. But then, you know, we started to get along. And as time went on, it just grew stronger and stronger and stronger.
Did she live with you?
At the end, we took care of her.
And you were, I feel like that you were more of like, no, your mom's coming to live here. She didn't even have to ask. It was like, no, there's no ifs, ands, or buts. Your mother is going to stay here. She didn't even have to say, Stephen, what do you think? Do you think we should take mom in? It wasn't even a question. Because this is what she did. When they put me like in a basement, it's just my symbol for that we lived together and we were always together.
We were.
So thanking you for doing everything for her. Did you tell her it was okay to let go? She wants to thank you for that.
When Diane lost her mother, it truly changed her. She still, to this day, hasn't been the same way she was when her mother was alive. We lost a part of Diane, hopefully one day to get that back, you know, but her life has definitely changed since she's passed away.
But now who's the father figure for you on the other side? Is your father departed? Because I just saw a street sign. That's usually my symbol for where someone names something or does something in memory of someone.
They named a street after my father.
They did? Oh, shut up.
He was the commissioner of the Bethpage Fire Department.
Perfect. So know that your dad knows what was done in memory of him.
When Theresa said that, I was shocked because there's no way she would know that.